My dear officers, I am happy to join you again at a conference like this after nearly 2 years. Let me place on record my appreciation of the efforts put in by the collectors, joint collectors and others in solving the problems of the people in ensuring effective implementation of the various schemes, policies and programs undertaken by the state government. I am glad that the district administrators, heads of departments and senior officials in the government have met here again to discuss the important problems facing the state and to set new goals in various activities and developmental programs. I would like you to discuss all the issues and come up with amicable solutions. I am happy to a large extent we have succeeded in translating into action most of the decisions taken in the last conference. I congratulate everybody for this. However, I would like to tell that we all know no functionary above or below the district collector enjoys such an enviable status, including the other district officers. This is because of the faith that governments have placed in this institution. However, I would like to caution some of the district officials, including collectors, on the need to maintain good public relations with people's representatives. The collectors must realize that the non-officials have an important role to play in democracy. The collectors must therefore carry the non-official machinery along with them. This will enable the collectors to discharge their functions in a more effective manner. It must be realized that once the non-official or a minister finds the collector receptive to his suggestions, he will assist the district administration in the better way of implementing the policies and programs of the government that were announced from time to time by the government. I draw your attention in particular to the need to provide drinking water, ensuring efficient functioning of fair price shops, cooperative and commercial banks, the primary health centers, hospitals and the primary and secondary schools. Along with this, we should ensure success of programs uppermost in the minds of the government, like implementation of ban on arak, efficient conduct of important programs like the total literacy program, the family planning program, which are aimed at the upliftment of the poor and the needy with particular emphasis on women. Finally, I would like to congratulate all district officials, including collectors, for their cooperation. Dear sir, in reply to your letter, we are sorry to inform you that we are unable to give special tariff for the chairs indicated in your letter. We shall be happy to supply you at the ordinary rates if you give your confirmed order. The chairs are of the best quality and let us have an order for these chairs so that we can make necessary arrangements to deliver the goods as per your order. As there is much demand for these chairs, we cannot make this offer beyond Saturday next. The terms and conditions are enclosed along with this letter. With regard to your other letter for the supply of office equipment such as computer tables, gift items for the coming new year, we have immediately forwarded your letter to our sister company at Bombay and they have given a wire to us indicating that they are shortly sending their representative to your office, thanking you, yours faithfully.